That's it.
What's up everyone, I'm Chris. We got Steph behind the camera and we're hungry to travel. We're continuing our Mexican street food tour today here in the historic and central neighborhoods of Mexico City. There's so much rich history and beautiful architecture around, along with some delicious food to be eaten. So let's get eating. Come on. We're starting our day off here at Los Machetes and Burrito for a very unique Mexico City dish that can only be found in the Guerrero neighborhood where we are today. And you can see behind me the massive machetes, and they get their name from the machete, from their look. So they look exactly like the knife, sword-like machete. And oh my gosh, they smell amazing. They are huge. So let's head inside and see how these big machetes are made. Los Machetes and Burrito has been around since 1964 making these machetes. And you can see here, they have 16 different guisados, which are ingredients put into them. They are pumping out these machetes for to-go, for people inside as well, for breakfast this morning. And there are just so many. The one we're gonna get is gonna include all 16 of these ingredients, so it's gonna be super special. So we just found out that the cook here is actually Señorita Emparito, which is the owner. Hola, muchas gracias. Buenísimo. Beautiful. It's such a nice family-run local business, from the matriarch, Señorita Emparito, to her daughter working here and her grandson helping out as well. This is just what you'd like to see here in Mexico. Amazing.
Look at that masa dough, that corn flour dough used to make the machetes.
Our Cubano 16 ingredient machete is cooking up real nice here. They are sizzling, and we were told that they are also gonna give us the champion machete to try as well. So we have a lot of food this morning to consume. Let's try.
So this.
Right there in the right, okay, there you go, squish it up. There you go, mix it in. Put the other hand under.
Oh,
yeah. This
like
way.
Like a baby. Right.
Line, yeah.
Squish
it up. Yeah. Hola, hola, hola. Okay. There you go. Put the hand under. There you go. One more round, and they're machetes, but more of a round
quesadilla.
Yeah, more round quesadilla. I'll leave the machete making to the professionals here who have been doing it for years and years. But my round machete, I'm not gonna subject someone to have this.
Muchas gracias. Oh, thank you so much. Delicious.
An amazing experience here at Los Machetes Amparito. Oh man, so fun. She's been making the machetes from the dough for over 35 years, so she is a master at making the perfect shape of the machetes. Probably hundreds and hundreds a day, right? Oh my gosh, wow. Gracias. You're the master.
She said that it looks very easy to make it, but it's really
hard. Oh, very difficult. Oh, yes, yeah. She makes it look so easy, though. Oh, gracias. Gracias. So here we have our gigantic machetes, and oh my gosh, these are huge. They are so long, about more than half a meter in length, like 60 centimeters. And we have it with salsa and the salsa verde here, along with a horchata and a hibiscus water. So this is a feast, and I don't even know how to start, but just look at how long this is. Like, I can't even pick it up without it breaking apart. Oh my gosh. But I'm gonna start with this one with the 16 different ingredients, the cubano. Oh man, and just come and check out all these ingredients here. Let's take a look under here. Oh my gosh, look how steamy that is. So it looks like we have bacon, ham, and we have the second half as well here. Wow, look at all of that. I think it's time to get a bite of this machete. It already snapped in half for me, so let's have this half first. Let's squeeze some lime on. But I'm really interested to try this black ingredient here, which is called huitlacoche, which is a corn fungus. Very interesting. It's a delicacy here in Mexico. Half machete. Cheers. Mm. So crispy and crunchy. Holy moly, look at that. Steaming hot. And the corn tortilla that they use is actually pretty thick. So there's a lot of dough here. That first bite though is a mushroom bite. You can see there all the mushrooms. Super flavorful. And honestly, piping hot. This is absolutely stuffed, and it's almost just like a gigantic quesadilla that is just filled to the brim with ingredients. So cheesy. And we've gotten to that special Mexican delicacy, the huitlacoche. Look at that, that color. I honestly just want to just take a little bit and try it on its own first. A super unique flavor, actually. It's sweet, savory, a bit sour, and smoky and earthy, kind of. It almost has like a touch of mushroom. That is very unique. I love the black color. Mmm, what a unique flavor. Never had something that tasted like that before. Wow, it's honestly a flavor explosion, this machete. There's so many ingredients. All of them are so unique and different. This is an experience. So this is horchata, which is a rice-based drink that's mixed with cinnamon, some other ingredients, but look at the color there. So white, and this is a super popular drink here in Mexico. So, cheers. Ooh, that is refreshing. It's like creamy for being a water-based drink, but you can really taste that rice flavor and the cinnamon in there. It kind of tastes like fall in Canada, to be honest. That is delicious. And here,
We have their popular drink as well, their hibiscus flavored water. Smells sweet. Look at that color too, so purple. Cheers. Ooh. Okay, that one is sweeter and has that a bit of like a sour flavor from the hibiscus, but oh, both so refreshing and complements the saltiness of the machete so well. We have our champion machete, and you can just see here just how long the machetes are here. So big, falling apart, you can't even hold it with two hands. Look at this, that crusty cheese here, and the champion is filled with beef, cheese, bell peppers, bacon. Oh my gosh, look at that. Again, it's steaming hot. That cheese, so crispy, amazing. The bell peppers, the bacon, the cheese. This champion, honestly, with all those ingredients, tastes like a Mexican deluxe pizza. Just so cheesy, so filled with those ingredients, so hot as well. Just exploding with flavor again, really. Mm. So the first salsa we have here smells so fresh. It's a green salsa verde made with chilies and other ingredients. Just look at that. Nice and runny. Okay, let's put a little bit on there because it could be spicy. And the second salsa we have here is called a Rojas salsa. So orangey red in color, also made with different chilies. So let's get some of that on. Okay, salsa machete bite. Mmm, that green salsa verde adds a bit of a kick to the machete. Oh, just so fresh tasting though, that is delicious. And let's try this Rojas salsa over here. Less spicy, but oh, also adds so much flavor. And look at this piece of bacon that just fell out. So much fat and meat there. A few last quesadillas that I want to try in this Cubano machete. We were told that this is pig brain. So flavorful, creamy, and rich as well, but mushy. It almost has like a gravy, peppery flavor to that. Mm. One of my favorite ingredients, I think, so far. And on the other end of the machete spectrum here, we have the chicharron ingredient, which is the fried pork skin. And you can see that there's pieces of pork in there as well, crispy pork skin. Oh, wow. Chicharron is so crispy. Fatty, meaty, and just greasy with the cheese. Can never go wrong with chicharron. Mmm, that pork, so tasty. This has been an unbelievable and such a unique Mexico City experience trying the famous machetes here in the Guerrero neighborhood at Los Machetes Emporito. The ingredients used here are so fresh and unique and tasty, and these are just gigantic. You can definitely share this amongst many people. I'm glad I have Steph here to share the rest of this with me. And the hospitality here has been second to none, so top notch. Everyone here from Señorita Emporito to her whole family and the staff here cooking these machetes have been so nice and hospitable. The Mexican hospitality has been amazing since we've been in Mexico City, and the food is just incredible. And here you can really see why they're called machetes. Look at that, looks exactly like a machete. So cool, so local here. And of course, we should just end with an ultimate machete bite. So, cheers. Muchas gracias. This is the whole family here at Los Machetes Amparito. The machetes were, oh my gosh, exquisito. Oh, delicious, delicioso. Amazing experience. If you're ever in Mexico City and the Guerrero neighborhood, definitely pay this legendary, iconic place a visit because the machetes are amazing. Muchas gracias.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Gracias
so much. Oh, amazing.
The historical center of Mexico City is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. It was built in the 16th century by the Spanish on the ruins of the old Aztec capital. The whole area is full of beautiful old colonial buildings, illustrating the past of the city. The architecture dates back hundreds of years, but the city itself is much older. Mexico City is the oldest capital city in the Americas and one of only two founded by indigenous people. It's now one of the world's largest cities and largest Spanish-speaking city in the world. We're here at Carnitas Rigo, which is a place that specializes in all things carnitas. Now, this big lump of meat on top is the carnitas. It is a slow cooked pork that takes several hours to cook, and they put it on all kinds of different things here. We got it on a sope, which is this interesting dish here in Mexico. It's made out of masa, so corn flour, and what makes it unique is the little pinched sides you can see here that they make with their fingers, and it ultimately keeps everything, all the ingredients, all the toppings inside of the sope. This sope, it's decently thick and they fry it so it's nice and crispy on the outside but a little soft on the inside. We've got it with refried beans on the bottom, a little bit of salsa, this queso cheese on top. Oh man, cheers. Mm. Oh my gosh, that meat. It's so tender and juicy and fatty. The pieces of fatty pork, so juicy and delicious, and such massive pieces of the pork itself.
It is piled high on that sope.
That is so good. The fat is just sticky. Oh my gosh, that is incredibly tender. And the meat, just has such a nice flavor to it. Wow. I can't believe how soft and tender that is. Okay, let's get a few things put on top here. All right, let's dress this sope. Got a couple onions here, a bit of salsa. Looks like we have a salsa verde with avocado in here. Possibly very spicy. Some cilantro. And of course, a little fresh lime juice on there. Oh, that's a really juicy lime. That's gonna be nice and fresh. Okay, now this is officially a loaded sope. It's a good job. We've got the little pinch sides to keep everything inside of here because it actually does a pretty good job. Okay, well, here we go. There is just something about the freshness of the salsas here in Mexico. It adds just such a dimension to the dish. When you've got something heavy like this with such a fatty meat, it just really cuts through it, especially that lime juice too. But oh my gosh, everything from the beans to the freshness of the onion is just all so good. The sope, the masa on the bottom, you can see like really keeps it together. Nothing soaks through because it's that little bit thick. And I just love how here in Mexico, that masa corn dough is so versatile. It's pretty much a plate for all the dishes here in Mexico. I just absolutely love it. And this cheese, can you get a look at that? Okay, this sope is really, really delicious. I just can't believe how many toppings you can get on top of here. But honestly, the star has to be that carnitas slow cooked pork. It is just incredibly tender and juicy. I just can't get over it. This is a decent meal and pretty hefty as well. Delicioso.
Our next stop is for another traditional Mexican dish, and this should be super stuffed with meat. And look at the lineup of this place.
So here now in the kitchen of Los Tres Queritos, and you can see behind me, they are preparing all of the delicious gorditas, and there's just so much pork. You can see chicharron, big slabs of the chicharron there, the skin, the pork skin, and all of this carnita pork here, and they're frying up the gorditas behind me there. So it just smells amazing in this kitchen, and those gorditas look amazing. Ah, gracias, señorita. Gracias. Look at this fresh chicharron here as a sample. So nice, the hospitality here. Oh, look at this. So fried. Oh my gosh, smells amazing. All right. So crispy, airy and fluffy almost, but just has that chicharron crisp. Wow, look at that. And again, yeah. Just so light, but has that pork skin flavor. Oh, that is delicious. Fatty tasting. Mm. Oh, rico. Oh, delicioso. So delicious. Yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers. Riquísimo. Riquísimo. Oh, amazing.
Gorditas de chicharrón.
Una especial. Digo, dos especiales.
Vamos. Con carne.
Una especial.
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 So here we have our gordita, and this is the gordita de chicharron special. You can see when they were making the gorditas, they were stuffing them first with the chicharron and then frying them, and then now it's stuffed with the meat inside, the pork meat, the carnita in there. Oh my gosh, look at that. It's like a little chubby sandwich, and funnily enough, gordita translates to chubby in Spanish. So this is a little chubby gordita, and oh my gosh, smells amazing. Let's just dig right into this. It is absolutely packed and so hot, fresh, coming straight out of the fryer there. Oh, cheers. Oh my gosh, the dough is just so crispy, made from that masa corn flour, and it's pretty thick, but just so hot and crispy. The meat, the carnita on the inside, just so meaty tasting, fatty from the fat from the pork, and the chicharron that's baked into the gordita dough. Mmm. Just salty goodness. You can look under the lid here. Oh my gosh, look at all of that meat. You can see right here, the masa dough is just pretty thick actually, but just again, so crispy. Wow, you can just see how red that meat is there. It's so salty and delicious. The salsa that she put on is actually pretty spicy, but the lime gives it a nice sweet and sour kick that really complements that spiciness. This whole gordita is just amazing. Such tender meat, fatty, and just salty chicharron taste. Such a unique, unique dish here in Mexico. Oh, exquisito. Gracias, gracias. Oh my gosh, muchas gracias. Oh, so good. Wow. And we were just given a complimentary Coca-Cola to go with our gordita here.
A little sweet, a little salty.
Okay. That is a good compliment here. And such a perfect street food right here. This is Mexican street food. A Coke with a gordita stuffed with carnita meat. Doesn't get much better than this. Oh, that's amazing.
All right, we're gonna finish our night off with something extremely cheesy and no, it's just literally cheesy. Come on. Queso fundido, and when we said cheese, we meant cheese. Look at this. Cheese and chorizo. Just straight up queso and chorizo. Oh my gosh. That is some stringy cheese. Oh my gosh. Now this is special to Mexico. It's pretty much cheese fondue, but something you just find here. And oh my gosh, I'm just gonna dive right in. Cheers. Oh my gosh, that is so rich. But honestly, the cheese actually isn't that salty. Oh my gosh. But that chorizo is salty. A little bit spicy, but just so flavorful. Oh my God, this is an indulgence. That is so delicious. I'm sure it can't be great for you, but it tastes good, and don't all the best things anyways? Oh man, look at that cheese. Just straight up queso. It is so stringy. Oh my God.
Now that's a cheese pull.
That is a cheese. I mean, look at this. Here we go. Let's just see how far we can go. I can't even go any higher. This is like the ultimate cheese drink. And Chris and I, we love cheese drinks. So it really doesn't get any more better than this. Oh my gosh. We can't forget our queso chicharron here. Just the fried cheese as it was put immediately on the grill. Mmm. Nice and crispy. Has a nice flavor of the grill to it. Oh. This is a cheesy, cheesy, rich, heavy dish to finish off our day. But I don't think I could be any happier, to be honest with you. Look at this. Oh, that is crispy. We've got a nice fresh glass of horchata to go with it. Oh, that is so good. This one is actually quite rich and thick compared to other ones that we've had. Oh, but that cinnamon flavor with it is just so nice. It actually complements the cheese and the heaviness of it really well. So with this, we got all these lovely side dishes that I'm just assuming we should put on our tortillas here. So let's grab a little bit of everything. We've got some cucumber, lettuce, and radish. We've we've got some potentially spicy salsa, something very creamy here that looks really tasty, a little bit of this red salsa there, and we've got some onions, and it looks like some pineapple here as well. Woo-wee! All right, and last but not least, we cannot forget this cheese and chorizo. Oh, almost can't forget a little bit of lime. All right, here we go. This is gonna be a huge bite. Something on there is insanely spicy. Oh, it's actually really tasty. There's so many different textures and flavors going on here, from the sweet pineapple to the crunchy cucumber, the nice zest of the lime, the cheese and the chorizo, but then also something along here, like I said, is super spicy. It's like burning my lips right now. But all in all, and with that soft tortilla, everything works really well together. I see why they do give you all these extra little side dishes to go with it. It really makes it like a complete meal. That's really good. Today has been a truly amazing day exploring Mexico City and trying some traditional Mexican street food. The hospitality we've experienced today has just been unparalleled. The people of Mexico have been so friendly and welcoming to us, and it has honestly just made our day today so special.
Whoa. I think you need to finish with an ultimate cheese queso bite.
Okay, you know what? Let's do it. Why not? You can never have too much cheese, right? Thanks so much for watching, everyone. That does it for our street food tour here in Mexico City today. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like, share with your friends and family, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel to come with us on all of our food adventures. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal. It's a good combo.